tonight's guest star, the guest star of Monday Night Raw, the star of Jersey Shore, New York Times best-selling author, Nicole Smithy Paluzzi, live here tonight. She's with Trish.
And ladies and gentlemen, from one pop icon to another. Hi, I'm Michael Cole, the voice of the WWE. And to ensure my protection from Jerry Lawler and the WWE Universe, I have built my broadcast palace, otherwise known as the Coal Mine, to ensure that I can continue to bring you broadcast journalism excellence at its best. Live tonight on Raw.
Awesome!
It is about making a statement. It is about getting ready for the main event at WrestleMania. We'd like to take you back to Raw 3 weeks ago, where, well, after they had won the tag team titles, Miz turned the tables around on John Cena.
The Miz had absolutely no intention of forming a union with John Cena. The Miz waited for the perfect opportunity to hide in plain sight and attack John Cena.
What a great plan for the Miz. And then, ladies and gentlemen, 2 weeks ago, it would be The Miz yet again, suckering John Cena in after the steel cage match between Cena and Miz's then-apprentice, Alex Riley.
Once again, another calculated ambush planned by the WWE Champion, The Miz, a skull-crushing finale outside the ring.
And you thought that was enough? No, it isn't. The Miz wasn't through. Last week, The Miz ambushing John Cena, sending a message to Cena and The Rock after Cena got done addressing the People's Champion.
Remember, The Miz had tweeted earlier that day that he was boycotting Raw, only to show up and get to John Cena with an assault from behind. If The Miz wasn't in John Cena's thoughts before, he certainly is now.
And this is what The Rock was alluding to moments ago. The Miz delivering the patented People's Elbow. That's The Rock's signature maneuver. Delivering it straight to the heart of John Cena. Mocking, humiliating The Rock, and sending a statement to Cena as we head to WrestleMania.
Really? Really? You know, the Rock's t-shirt says, I bring it. And I couldn't agree with you more, Rock. You do bring it. You bring out-of-date catchphrases. You bring bad tattoos, you bring horrific movies, you bring empty promises and pointless 20-minute diatribes that only a has-been can bring. And you have a problem with me insulting your family. Let me remind you, Rock, your father and your grandfather were both good.
Yes, he does.
Are you done? Back to what I was saying. Your father and your grandfather were both good, but they were never WWE champion. So that means I'm better than the both of them, and I can say whatever I want. And you like to make six-year-olds cry. Lil Rock, step into this ring, and I'm going to make you cry. I'm going to make you scream like a little girl. Because unlike you, instead of talking about beating up John Cena, I've actually done it. 3 weeks in a row, to be exact. So no, Rock, You don't own John Cena. I do. That doesn't faze me. Nothing you people say fazes me. So, Rock, week after week after week via television screen, you say that you're gonna bring it. And I hope, I pray that you do bring it, Rock. Hey, who knows? He might bring it here to St. Louis. But if you do bring it here, or anytime you bring it, just let it be known that you will be overshadowed by the most must-see WWE champion in the history of this company.
I think your cage is cleaned out by now. Miz, seems that tonight the Raw General Manager is arranging two first-time ever matches for yourself and John Cena. Later tonight, John Cena will face a man he's never been in the ring with before. The number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship, Alberto Del Rio.
Yeah, but what about me? There's nobody for me to face. I've beaten everybody there is to beat.
Well, that's not entirely true, Miz. The fact is, apparently you've never faced this man. Great Khali! Now this is certainly must-see. The must-see champion didn't want to see. This is a travesty. Look at the size of the Great Khali.
Why would you even read that, Lawler? Why would you even read that? The WWE champion shouldn't have to face the Punjabi Nightmare 3 weeks from WrestleMania. This is ridiculous. You should be fired. Everybody should be fired.
This is gonna be great.